everyone, my name is Ayamute and I'm going to show you how to form a simple present tense and when to use simple present tense. Before we get started, it's good to know that when I say first person singular, it means I, and when I say second person singular, it means you, and when I say third person singular, it means she, he, and it. And when I say first person plural, I mean we. And when I say second person plural, I mean you. And when I say third person plural, I mean they. Now let's get started. Let's take a look at these sentences. I eat breakfast every morning. They play football every Sunday. Both these sentences are in simple present tense. This is how to form a simple present tense. Okay, for the first and second person in singular forms, we simply use the infinitive form of the verb. For example, I swim in the river. You read the book. For all four forms, we do the same. We simply use the infinitive form of the verb. We walk to school. We ride your bike. We study English. For the third person singular form, she, he, and it, we do something else. We use the infinitive form of the verb, but we add an S or an ES. For example, he walks home. She plays hockey. It sells books and stationeries. We need to pay an extra attention when the verb ends in CH, SH, S, X, and Z. Sounds such as kiss and catch. We use the infinitive form of the verb, but we add an ES. This is the example. He misses his wife. She teaches English. For verbs ending in Y, change the Y to an IE and then add an ES, such as spy, fly, envy, and worry. And their sentence would look like this. He spies on his neighbors. She envies her cousins. It worries me a lot. Now let's take a look at the simple present tense in question forms. Okay, for the first and the second person singular form, we need the auxiliary verb to do and the infinitive form of the verb. These are examples. Do I need a ticket? Do you speak English? The same goes for all plural forms. Do we make the beds ourselves? Do you ride your bike? Do they work on the farm? For the person singular form, we also use the verb auxiliary to do, but we conjugate it to does, and even the form of the verb. Does he ride the bike often? Does she cut your hair? Does it work on batteries? Now let's take a look at the simple present tense in negations. For the first and second person singular form, we again use the verb auxiliary to do, but we add not, so it became don't, and the infinitive form of the verb. The examples: I don't need a ticket. You don't speak English. For all plural forms, we do the same. They don't walk to school. You don't ride your bike. They don't listen to the radio. For the third person singular, we again use does, but we add not, so it become doesn't, and the infinitive form of the verb. He doesn't clean his house. It doesn't work on batteries. Okay, now let's take a look at when we use the simple present tense. First, we use the simple present tense for habitual activities, things that happen every time, or not really every time, like things that happen always, such as every day and constantly, regularly, such as often and frequently, sometimes, such as occasionally and rarely, and never. For example, I play football every Saturday. He regularly visits his grandmother. We rarely go to shopping in London. They never work late on Friday. Number two, we also use simple present tense for facts. The sun rises in the east. Plants need water. And number three, we use simple present tense for schedules. The bus leaves at 6 o'clock. The train departs from platform 2. The flight arrives at Gate 3. This is all that I can show you. And don't forget to like, subscribe, or share the video to your friends. Let's get everyone educated, and thanks for watching. Bye!